B-Rat here, Buzz TV. It's a fun day for us. It's the day after Thanksgiving. I'm here with Aaron Nordstrom from Gemini Syndrome. Hey, Aaron, how you doing?
Good evening.
It's great. Haven't seen you for a while.
Post-Thanksgiving evening.
And post-COVID, we're able to actually deal with each other, which is a nice thing. Ooh, you see the hairs are standing up?
Physical touch.
So let's just dive into this stuff. Tour's going well so far?
Yep. It's been fantastic. We did like kind of our first run in July, August, and then a four-week run here in November. It's been good.
Where are we going after this?
This is it. We go to Reno for one more show, and we're done. So I'm kind of looking at this like, you know, this is the last show in my... Not really. Reno, you're the last show. Don't get me wrong. But I got to see my dogs and stuff today, so I'm home, right? I'm in that mindset.
Yeah, that's the best thing. Now, there's a new album out, and that's the biggest thing. Let's talk about that.
Third Degree, The Raising.
How many tracks? Enough.
A bunch. I think like 12 or 13.
Now,
100.
Now, with the band, like you're in Vegas and other guys are in L.A., when it comes to
No. We're all in Vegas.
Everyone's
now.
In Vegas
yeah,
now.
We all moved here.
Okay.
This really is home for me and the band now.
See, because it's been like, I think, 4 or 5 years since we spoke. Well, then that kind of changes the question.
They
showed up
probably the last time. It was about a year after you and I saw each other last talking about that stuff. And I finally convinced them all to get over here.
Well, then that means writing is now a much easier process because everyone's in a
20-minute drive,
place.
Right? And we also, like, everybody learned over the pandemic to do everything remotely. Like, we can even work from home across town at this point, you know?
Oh, that's
cool.
Nice.
And just wake up and get on a Zoom call, and I don't have to drive over there, you know?
Very cool. Now, how did recording the album go? Smooth and easy process?
Actually, yeah. It was couldn't have been easier. I was in and out in 9 days. I took 2 days off from my throat. I recorded the whole record in a week. By the time I got there, we went with like 15 or 16 songs, and I showed up, and they'd written 7 more in the 2 weeks that I didn't go to Phoenix. So I had 7 more songs to write. 5 of those made it to the record. So half that album is written in the studio while we recorded everything.
Very cool. So, you know, it's nice you guys were able to gel like that and just knock that thing out.
Yeah.
Now, with the band, the guys are out there doing some stuff. Let's show some love. Who has endorsement deals or sponsorships? I love to show love to those guys.
Schecter Guitars, for sure. I know
Scum Love. Gotta love Scum.
Scum Love. We love Scum. He's going to actually hook me up with an acoustic Schecter that I picked out. I think it's called the Orleans Studio I looked at last night. It's like a dark wood finish. Very pretty.
Oh, very cool. We'll be bumping into him at NAMM coming up.
Yeah. I want to say that Brian uses DW specifically, and I hope I get that right. I'm pretty sure. Out of Oxnard, right?
Exactly.
AP plays Music Man. I know everybody's using Kempers at this point. I know AP's been endorsed by Ashdown in the past.
Very cool. And I love Kempers myself, so as a guitar player, it's like you guys are hooked up. Very nice.
I have a custom mic stand by a guy named Ryan Kilpatrick. He just made me on this tour. We have a company, Rebel Iron, that's made us some really cool stuff in the past that does iron work for us. So all those guys, we appreciate them.
Oh, that's a great thing because, you know, without people like that, you can't be yourselves.
That's right.
They make everything else so much more visually exciting.
Level Up Beard Company, endorsed by them. They make fine beard products.
Exactly. Got to be looking good. Well, you have to be looking good, that is.
They tell me, you know.
I'm not there, and I don't think I will be.
We're both beautiful
humans. I do got to die. Get
we're,
a die job.
We're beautiful
going.
Humans, dude.
Exactly.
You know.
So you're home.
Yeah.
You got to spend time with the dogs. And it's funny because we just picked up another one, so I love that.
We have a puppy now, too. She's 5 months old. She's the one that ate my glasses.
Well, that's what they do. I think mine is into digging holes and tearing up the sprinkler lines. I had to go patch a line again today. It's like...
Oh, that sounds like a fun game.
Oh, it's such a fun
game.
Because every couple days I'm doing it, the wife's out there going, what the hell? And I go, oh, yeah, Rogue out and got the sprinklers again.
Yeah.
So let's see. We spoke about the album. We spoke about endorsements. There's one more Reno date coming.
Yeah.
Probably the most important question I could ask in any interview is, what did we leave out that they need to know about Gemini Syndrome?
Well, the new album is probably the most important part of that, right?
And we could get that in normal places?
Yeah, I mean, where do you get albums anymore? We just had this whole conversation last night with Heidi from the Butcher Babies,
right? You know what it
is?
It's albums these days. We have to go to your website.
That's right. That's the right answer.
And what is the website for them to go to?
on the World Wide Web at www.geminisyndrome.com.
We'll have links right down there. It should be flashing in your face right now as well.
So www.geminisyndrome.com.
So you could go there, get some vinyl stuff. I know you guys are putting out vinyl.
So, funny story about that. There is a worldwide vinyl shortage right now.
You're kidding me.
It's not even a joke. So, we will have vinyl. Hopefully, I think they said February is when we should be able to print those out again. But there is literally a vinyl shortage in the world.
That's insane. I knew there were shortages. Never thought vinyl would be one of them.
And we did finally get our physical copies in. You can go to the website. CDs?
Get CDs.
CDs. You can CDs. You know?
And you can always do the digital stuff in all the right places. Apple, CD Baby. There's got to be links on your site. So you can pick all that fun stuff up. And in February, you're going to get that tasty vinyl.
We're looking at booking out the rest of next year now. So we'll be back on the road probably around February, March.
Oh, it's a perfect time.
And
get
through,
on the road,
through
pick
the spring,
vinyl. And,
through the spring, we'll be doing some festivals, I think. And should be a busy year for us.
We'll update all that stuff. So you guys come back. We'll have tour.
Right now, go get the record. You can go. We got a bunch of dope merch that just came out at the store.
In fact, we'll be picking some of that up. Now, let's see. We haven't done this in a while, but I love to do it because it's the best thing in the world. We have a fun little game called Roll the Bones.
Oh, I love games.
I got a 30-sided dice. We're not doing D&D, and I have 30 pre-selected questions. I think 4 or 5 even deal with music.
Come on, 23. Without cheating.
That is 10 on the top.
All right, that's a good number.
And 10.
That was Pythagoras' favorite number because 10 represented the whole of creation.
Okay, this is fun. Kind of a music question. What was the first song you learned to play?
I started playing piano when I was about 3. Cool. I have no idea. First song I learned to play on the guitar was Come As You Are by Nirvana. The second song I learned to play was Smell Like Teen Spirit.
Okay, there you go. For me, that was simple. Smoke on the Water. I think that was almost everybody's first song back in the day.
That was probably my third one that I learned, right?
Okay.
So after I learned Smells Like Teen Spirit, I could do the power chords. So then you could do...
That's what Smoke on the Water is for. It's just straight
right.
power chords
That's
up
it.
And down.
That's it.
Okay, so I will take a spin at this lovely adventure, and I got a 18. And 18 for me is...
The moon card in the...
Oh, food I hate, that's easy. We just got done with Thanksgiving. The sweet potatoes, can't stand them.
Huh. I'm not a huge fan, but black licorice.
Ooh, yeah, I'm not a big fan of that one either, black
Which
licorice.
Which is funny,
isn't
because
good.
When I did drink, I loved Jägermeister. But I hate black licorice.
See, I didn't drink
with a passion.
Every so often, you could get me Goldschlager shots.
Oh.
But Ooh. It's like, Vinny, it's like Ooh. When you're in that camp, it's all Jaeger.
Yeah.
And I don't drink Jaeger, and I always got the dirtiest to look.
Did they ever make you drink a Starry Night?
Yes.
There's Jaeger and the thing you just said?
Yeah, and I hurled.
Yeah, it's bad news. Kansas ones back in the day.
So that's why I don't let them force me to drink. Well, look, my friend, I appreciate you taking the time. I know you got some stuff to do.
I appreciate you taking your time.
Oh, well,
and letting me break all your stuff.
That's what insurance is for. And he didn't break anything.
I just kicked a bunch of shit that I didn't see like a savage human.
It's like me. When you wear glasses, you don't see shit. They say it helps you, but they lie.
Yeah, it's actually just a barrier in front to block out all the bullshit.
Exactly. Well, guys, this was really fun. You're going to see some great stuff. We got some 8K VR. We got the 4K cameras rolling.
I can't even see that shit.
So sit back. Enjoy. For myself, for Aaron, for Gemini Syndrome, the Backstage Bar and Billiards here in Las Vegas and Buzz TV. We're out of here, guys.
We're touching each other physically, not in a weird way.
See ya.
What's up, you beautiful motherfuckers? For you. Yeah!
How many OG sinners we got in this fucking room tonight?